Happy MLK Day. And happy Mardi Gras. Time to go get it. Happy MLK, fellas. Happy detailing. Some of you guys might be chilling, relaxing. I got two to go get, so I'm gonna go knock them out. Bring you guys along with me for a little bit.
Turn left onto Carriage Drive, then turn right onto Burma Road. Turn right onto Burma Road. In a quarter mile, turn left onto Demetropolis Road.
Some people don't want all that. Some people don't. Some people just want to just, you know, do what they regularly do, make the just the amount that they can make or whatever, and, you know, they cool with it. They may see a little profit or whatever, and that's all they, you know, want to do. Me, myself, I'm on a different route, a different road in my life. I've been on that road for a long time. It's not easy. But it is obtainable and it is possible. I've accomplished a lot of my missions that I've set out to do in my business. But Jim Jones, that podcast made a very, very, it was a good one. I forgot the name, I think it was Millionaire Mind State. But are you that person that will, you'll work on holidays if the family, you know what I'm saying, y'all got some plan to vacation and what's something, you got a big gig coming up. Will you let them go? you stay back and handle your business to feed and grow the brand. Me personally, I know my answer for me. Today, MLK Day, I got two lined up. Tomorrow, the Harvey Wednesday, a few more things lined up at the shop. But I'm willing to sacrifice basically everything for this right here. And that's the God honest truth. So ask yourself that, detailer. What are you willing to sacrifice? Are you willing to, or do you even have or want that millionaire mindset? I see a lot of people, they talk about some of the equipment that you get, that people buy. People buy what they buy for their own personal reasons. If you type that just like to buy cheap brand equipment, I mean, ain't nothing wrong with that, that's you. And then sometimes it's hell. Some people can't afford certain things at certain times, which, hell, it's a part of life. It is what it is. These just facts. But me personally, at this point in time, and I started it early on, when it comes to like some equipment that I gotta use on a regular basis, I don't normally try and, if I can't afford that time, yeah, of course I'm gonna go buy a cheaper brand if I need it right then. But for the majority of the times, I'm able to been blessed to be able to get what I want. And I'm gonna get a tool or a piece of equipment that's of quality versus, you know, price. But like I said, that's to each his own. But back to that, what are you willing to sacrifice? You just wanna hustle? Be a fly-by-nighter. The one thing I had to learn early also is I had to stop thinking like a detailer. I had to stop thinking like a car washer. Because if you out here and you plan on making this a longevity thing, me personally, I'm eventually want to grow my hustle into a business. But like I say, everybody's different. It's a nice challenge with the red wheels.
Mexico Heights. I'm going to go to the hospital.